feature Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Rainbow Six Patriots, The Division,
Bonjour tout le monde, c'est Max, je suis de retour pour le début de la conférence de Electronic Arts. Cette fois-ci, on va avoir exclusivement du contenu de EA. On a eu un petit aperçu durant la conférence de Microsoft parce que Peter Moore est allé sur la scène de Xbox pour présenter des nouveautés concernant le EA Access, notamment Titanfall qui est rendu un jeu gratuit pour les abonnés de EA Access, mais aussi Dragon Age Inquisition, donc ça c'est deux titres très intéressants. Pendant la pause, puis que je travaillais pour faire les résumés, j'étais allé voir sur ma console, voir si je pouvais télécharger ça, et l'Xbox Live est en erreur présentement. La conférence commence à l'instant, on se met un peu de volume puis on regarde ça ensemble. Évidemment, vous pouvez interagir avec moi directement sur le chat de Twitch. De la franchise Mass Effect avec un nouveau titre qui va s'appeler Andromeda. Au fait, 2016, donc c'est encore assez loin, on a le temps d'y penser, hein? Vous avez le temps.
Mass Effect Andromeda from our storytellers at BioWare. Welcome everyone to our show here at Shrine Expo Hall in Los Angeles. Thanks to those of you watching on our live stream and thanks to our audience here with us today. We're joined by players from our community, journalists from around the world, and our colleagues and partners from our great industry. This year, we're also excited to be hosting more than 300 high school and university students from across Greater Los Angeles. Welcome. I hope we can inspire and entertain you with what you see here today. This is going to be an action-packed show, chock full of new games you'll be able to play either this year or next. Play. Let's talk about that for just a moment. It's a simple idea. We think the world is a better place when we all make time to play. For us at EA, our passion for play is what inspires us to get up in the morning. It's what focuses us. We live to play, and it drives us to do our very best to create the next amazing experience. To immerse you in new worlds, to imagine new characters that will draw on your emotions, to transport you into adventures that capture your imagination. Play is our shared passion. It's what connects us with all of you. So here we go. We've got more than a dozen new experiences to share, and here's a little taste. Over the next few minutes, you'll see three original IPs, including one that I promise is unlike anything you're expecting. Later, we have a special guest, a living legend from the world of sport. And how about Mirror's Edge? Faith is back, and we have the exclusive first look. And of course, Star Wars. It's the year... It's the year of Star Wars here at EA with games for console, PC, and mobile. We have news on each of them today, including, of course, our grand finale, Star Wars Battlefront. I'll leave you with a couple of final thoughts. Putting players first continues to be our focus at Electronic Arts. It's a commitment that inspires everything that you're going to see here today. More games to play brought to life by our talented teams pioneering new ideas with cutting-edge new technology. More ways to play driven by what we learn each day through our conversations with you. Thank you. You make us better. No, thank you. Let's get into the action. As someone who loves cars, I can tell you this next game is stunning. But enough from me, let's check out the return of Need for Speed.
Electronic Arts qui va ouvrir sa conférence avec son premier jeu qui va être Need for Speed, donc une nouvelle itération de cette franchise-là, comme à toutes les années.
Searching for perfection. The fearless always push the limit. Or crave the thrill of the chase. Some only ride with their crew, but all do it for the reputation. How you drive, it's up to you.
That is the new Need for Speed, inspired by some of the most beloved games in the series, from the customization of Underground to the world of Carbon, from the narrative style of Most Wanted to the innovation and visuals of Rivals. We are bringing 20 years of history together for the definitive Need for Speed experience. So, welcome to Ventura Bay, home to five real-world icons who are the heroes of today's car culture. Build reputation and earn their respect on your journey to become the ultimate icon. From dusk to dawn, discover a rich open-world environment that's roughly twice the size of Rivals and drive the sweeping hillside roads to the police-infested urban districts with tight city corners. You can explore it, race it, and own it. The visual leap forward, thanks to Frostbite's physically based rendering, will make you question whether it's real or in-game, from the realistic world to the iconic cars. But how do you make it your own? By delivering the richest customization ever seen in a Need for Speed game. Your ride is built with the hottest authentic aftermarket brands, performance tuning, and personalized car handling. This is the customization our fans have been asking for. And when you're behind the wheel, we're bringing you a new kind of narrative that will pull you through your experience. Built around our icons are five action-packed, overlapping stories where every choice, every second, every minute propels your progression through our five ways to play. First, we have speed. Fully committed focus on top speed and maximum adrenaline. Next is style. Sliding, jumping, dancing your car across the fully open world in a cloud of smoke. Build, the never-ending search for your perfection in how your car looks, sounds, and drives. Crew, blasting through the streets with your friends inches away from wiping each other out. And finally, outlaw, the thrill of the chase and the chaos that that brings. All combined to create that perfect Need for Speed moment, driving insanely fast, sliding through a corner in your customized ride alongside your friends while being chased by cops. You specialize or you switch between them to become the ultimate icon. And when you do, you'll earn the respect and the recognition you deserve. Coming November 3rd, this is the new Need for Speed.
Pour Need for Speed arrive le 13 novembre prochain, donc on va voir, on dit que ça mêle un peu un univers de Need for Speed Carbon avec la jouabilité de Most Wanted, donc c'est intéressant, c'est à voir. But the knock I saw, every panel was a single brushstroke. It was a masterpiece.
precisely why I'm worried he'll never come.
Don't worry. He'll come.
Yo, guys, some big names in town. Let's get out there and get noticed.
Manu just asked to meet up.
Ultimate Shred, man, seriously. This is gonna be off the hook.
Ok, ce qu'on remarque, c'est qu'au niveau de la jouabilité, ça a l'air super excitant. C'est très typique Need for Speed, donc très arcade aussi. Les courses de nuit, les effets de lumière sont super beaux, puis on voit qu'il y a une espèce de flou artistique là, qui est posé aussi sur l'écran, probablement pour aider les calculs au niveau des consoles, puis masquer un peu les défauts. Mais c'est un effet qui fonctionne super bien. C'est un effet qu'on avait utilisé d'ailleurs dans Need for Speed Most Wanted en 2005 ou en 2006, qui était le titre original à l'époque. Pour moi, ça fonctionne jusqu'à maintenant. J'aime ce que je vois, donc c'est un bon point parce que vous le savez, moi, les chars, j'aime ça.
Consider yourself noticed. We'll be in touch.
Star Wars The Old Republic offers RPG gamers the chance to step into the center of their own Star Wars saga. So if you love Star Wars and want a deep experience, then start playing now and get ready, because something new is on the way. Our fans have told us exactly what they want in the future. More story, BioWare-style story, with a player-driven arc where choices matter. And we've been listening. Today, I'm proud to announce that we are taking Star Wars The Old Republic back to the roots of BioWare-style storytelling with the release of our new expansion, Knights of the Fallen Empire. This is your story, your way, and it's coming October 27, 2015. Knights of the Fallen Empire puts you in the center of the battle against a dangerous new enemy faction. You will choose your path. You will join or betray companions old and new, and you will make choices that will shape the fate of the entire galaxy, as well as your own. The expansion will deliver on the hallmarks of what makes a great BioWare game: new worlds to explore, new companions to recruit, and a dynamic story that players will be able to shape based on the choices they make. And in appreciation of our players' support over the years, Knights of the Fallen Empire will be free to all of our subscribers. I'll leave you with a first look at the story of Knights of the Fallen Empire. Thank you, and may the Force be with you.
a man can have. Une nouvelle expansion pour Star Wars The Old Republic, donc les joueurs qui adorent cette franchise-là et les styles très narratifs de BioWare vont pouvoir s'en mettre plein la bouche et plein les dents, avec plein les yeux aussi avec ce nouveau jeu-là, donc c'est à voir. Ce jeu-là a vraiment l'air débile. Ça a vraiment l'air bon.
That's a massive new expansion from BioWare, and the first Star Wars game we will show you today. Star Wars Battlefront comes a little later, but there's a lot more to get to first. Across EA Studios, we are all creators. It's a role we take very seriously to imagine, build, and deliver the experiences that will inspire and amaze all of you as players. For us, players first take on a very special meaning. It all starts with gameplay. Whether it's a blockbuster franchise or something entirely fresh and new, it all comes back to how well it actually plays. But it's not just up to us. We need your input as well. We're listening to you, your feedback, every day. We're hosting more community members in our studios, bringing you in to meet with our development teams. This year we'll hold more betas and playtests that get you into the games before launch. We want your feedback to help shape the experiences that we create. The direct conversation we have with you is where we can come together as players and game makers. The shared passion we have for play drives creativity in all our games, including the next two original IPs we're about to show you. The first one is unlike anything else you'll see here today. A year ago, I went to see this group called Coldwood in northern Sweden. The moment I saw the game they're making, I knew we had to bring it to all of you. It's an experience that is emotional and deeply creative, centered on a tiny character with a huge heart. This is Unravel.
Hello everyone. My name is Martin Salin, and that is Jarni. And I'm going to tell you all about that in a moment, but let me first just say that it feels so great to be here on this stage. I'm just so happy to finally be here and get to show you all this game that we made, this little thing called Unravel. I'm the creative director at Coldwood. We're a little studio made up of 14 people from Umeå in northern Sweden. And I think that games are really powerful things. They have the ability to grab you and move you in a way that few other art forms can. And that gives us as game makers a certain responsibility, I think. We should try to do more than to just entertain. And Unravel was created in that spirit. It was born out of the need to make something more personal, something with a heart. It's a puzzle platformer where you play as a little character made of yarn, which unravels as you move. And the yarn, it represents love and the bonds that we make. And it unravels because that's what happens when we're separated from what we love. In this game, you are the red thread that runs through someone's life, trying to tie all their missing pieces back together. Now, I made most of this design while I was on a camping trip with my family, way out in the countryside. I was so full of ideas, but I didn't have a lot of tools to work with out there, so I figured I could just kind of like act out the gameplay. And that's how Yarny came to be. And I actually brought him with me. Hi! No.
Je pense que le monsieur est un petit peu nerveux, malheureusement. Mais c'est des choses qui arrivent, il faut comprendre que les développeurs ne sont pas tous des présentateurs professionnels, donc c'est bien normal.
I wanted the whole game to feel just like that too. Like it's an exploration, it's a quest where you have to be clever and creative to find the proper path. And the game is centered on Yarny. This little character was on a big journey and accomplishing big things despite being so small. The gameplay is all physics-based. You have to find the way forward and overcome all these obstacles that you'll come across. And those problems can have simple solutions, like using your yarn to swing across a gap, or sometimes things might get more complex. So when you look back at that tangled and winding weave of yarn left behind you, you have to stop and wonder how you ever got there. It's kind of like life. I mean, I certainly didn't see myself standing here today back when I was playing with Yarny out in the woods 2 summers ago, but here I am, and I am really, really glad that I finally get to share this game with you all. Unravel. Thank you. Unravel means a lot to us at Coldwood. We put our hearts into this, and we hope that when you play it, you will feel that. So thank you, and enjoy.
Ça, c'est le genre de nouveau IP que j'aime beaucoup. C'est vraiment un nouveau style, quelque chose qu'on n'a jamais vu avant ou presque, qui apporte des nouvelles idées, donc dans un petit platformer comme ça qui peut être super cute puis super intéressant. Et le style visuel qui ressemble un peu à une espèce de pâte à modeler aussi, j'aime beaucoup. Donc j'ai hâte de voir ça. Ça va être bien intéressant. Le jeu s'appelle Unravel, vous allez pouvoir avoir plus de détails sur unravelgame.com. Bon, ok, là je pense qu'on va parler de Plants vs Zombies Garden Warfare 2 avec la toune Danger Zone de Top Gun. C'est n'importe quoi.
You can't take zombies anywhere. Go big, go crazy, have fun. This is Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. When we released Garden Warfare in 2014, it quickly became a runaway hit. From people like me who play the game with their kids, to the most competitive of gamers, over 6 million players fell in love with this shooter that doesn't take itself too seriously. Now, in Garden Warfare 2, Dr. Zomboss, the evil genius leader of the zombies, has finally discovered a way to turn the tide of battle and take suburbia from the plants. We put you in an all-new world where, for the first time in franchise history, the plants are on the attack. Now, joining you in this new world are six crazy new character classes from the past, the present, and the future, each armed with outrageous weapons and abilities that will introduce a new strategic layer of depth to your battles. Now, here to give you your very first look with a live gameplay demo, producer Kyle Duncan, creative director Justin Wiebe, and members of the Garden Warfare 2 development team. Guys?
Hello, and welcome to ZTech Industries. Today we're getting our first look at a brand new map, Zomboss Factory, built by Dr. Zomboss as part of his ongoing war effort to create Zomburbia. Today is not going to be an ordinary day. To defend the factory. We're going to live gameplay of our new four-player zombie co-op mode, Graveyard Ops. Our first new class is the Imp.
Vous avez trouvé ça comment, vous, le premier Garden Warfare? Moi, j'ai aimé ça, mais je me suis tanné rapidement. D'ailleurs, il est disponible gratuitement dans le Vault de EA Access présentement si vous êtes abonné.
The Imp is the smallest, fastest, and possibly craziest zombie in the game. Here is Super Brains, the zombie's all-new melee class. This is Captain Deadbeard, the zombie's first sniper class. Looks like the Imp is going to need something just a little bit bigger.
Des personnages un peu plus gros comme ça, un peu plus géants, ça a l'air pas mal cool par exemple. Ça, c'est une nouveauté assez intéressante. J'ai hâte de voir.
Awesome teamwork, everyone. It's time to evacuate.
Okay, let's get out of here. Eject! Eject! Great job, zombies.
Awesome job, guys. How fun does that look? So Graveyard Ops, our zombie co-op mode we just saw, was our number one most fan-requested feature. Now, a close second was the ability to play the game single player. Now, in Garden Warfare 2, you can play multiplayer with or against your friends. And for the very first time, we are introducing a unique solo play experience, where you can play every single game mode by yourself against AI, or with the help of a friend via local split screen. This, combined with other surprises, will offer a new twist in how you experience this universe. Now, your feedback has played a major role in the development of Garden Warfare 2. So as a thank you, we're giving all players of the original Garden Warfare the ability to transfer almost all of their unlocked characters directly into Garden Warfare 2 right from launch. We think this is an awesome way to kickstart this all-new adventure with your favorite plants and zombies. Now, Garden Warfare 2 will launch in spring 2016, but this is just the beginning. We feel that if you invest your time in our game, that we should invest in you with free content updates. We will continue to deliver free content updates long after launch, to ensure that Zomburbia stays action-packed.
Ça, c'est une grosse nouvelle parce qu'on sait que du côté de EA, normalement, les extensions et les updates de contenu supplémentaires sont payantes. Donc, pour Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2, on annonce que le contenu supplémentaire sera gratuit. C'est une grosse nouvelle.
Gentlemen, the way we're playing out there, that isn't gonna cut it. Not in this league. Not in any league. All that matters is what we do with these next 20 minutes. So ask yourself, what makes a team great? Is it talent? Or is it teamwork? Is it doing whatever it takes to win? Not for yourself.
C'est intéressant de voir du NHL au E3. Ça fait changement un petit peu dans les sports présentés, puis ça nous touche un peu plus directement ici au Québec. Moi, je suis un grand fan de NHL.
One more shot. Play the next 20 minutes for each other and lead the ice as champion.
Team is at the heart of hockey, and this year it's at the heart of NHL 16. And nowhere is that more true than in our all-new EA Sports Hockey League for the ultimate in team competition. This year we spent more time listening and working with fans than ever before. And that feedback is helping us create innovation throughout NHL 16. Today I'd like to talk about great things happening across EA Sports, so let's keep going with that theme of innovation. On July the 14th, Rory McIlroy PGA Tour launches as the first EA Sports game built using our Frostbite engine, opening up the golf experience. With the ability to stream full courses, players will truly be able to play the ball as it lies, no matter where it lands. Plus, no load times between holes shaves up to 15 minutes off your round. We've got stunning real-world courses and epic fantasy experiences. I mean, look at that. Very cool. This is golf without limits. Now, EA Sports Ultimate Team is where you build, manage, and play with your personal dream team. It connects our games to the heartbeat of sport throughout the season and beyond.
Pour être honnête, le système de cartes et de Ultimate Team, j'ai jamais accroché à ça. Peu importe le jeu de EA, c'est vraiment pas ma tasse de thé. Mais je comprends qu'il y a des gens qui aiment ça et qui vont être contents de revoir ces modes-là revenir dans des jeux comme NHL.
And we're committed to ensuring a safe and secure play environment. So no matter your sport, Ultimate Team will be fun and fair for everyone. And we want you to get the most out of your game. So this year, we're going to make you a better player. If you are new to EA Sports, we want to get you in the game. If you're a veteran player, we want to take your skills to the next level. New modes in FIFA and NHL give you contextual feedback on how to make better crosses or how to snipe that perfect wrist shot. And here, in Madden NFL, we've got training right in the game. There's even on-screen help to get you the skills and game knowledge to get right in. So, let's move on to our next big game. Here is NBA Live executive producer, Sean O'Brien.
Thank you, sir. Basketball is a game of self-expression. NBA superstars constantly amaze me with their flair, both on and off the court. Now check out that outfit. And you know what? NBA Live 16 is rooted in self-expression. This comes to life in both how you look and how you play, so that your entire in-game journey is all about you. And it's made possible through a feature set requested by basketball video game players because we make it a priority to listen to you. And what you see today is a direct result of that. It starts with self-expression off the court, with a brand new app that features our exclusive GameFace HD scanning tech. And I want to show you just how easy it is to use and how good you're going to look in game. Now we've got our NBA Live community manager, the Hoop God, here to help you. Come on up here, Hoop God. Where are you? There you are. How are you?
What's up, Hoop? How are you doing, man?
All right.
I see LA's been good to you.
Oh, really?
Light work.
All right. All right, Hoop God. So let's show them how to do this. Here you go. Here's the app. I'll hold your hat for you. Pause right there. So you can see he's trying to fill his face in this circle right there. Pressing the camera gut. That's right. Slowly to the right, back to the middle, and now to the left. And that's it. So what's happening right now, the app is actually generating a scan. It takes about 5 seconds. And it's going to generate a preview for us. Oh, it's ready. Here we go. Let's take a look.
Damn, that looks just like me.
There we go.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. You're going to fix the bald spot, though, right?
Oh, yeah. We'll take care of that in-game. Don't worry about it. We got you. NBA Live 16 hits the streets September 29th, and this app will be available before the game launches.
So, get ready to get yourself fresh, people just like me, the Hoop God.
All right, Hoop God, thanks for your help.
All right, man.
Get out of here. So in just a few minutes, the HD scan brings you to life in the game just like the NBA stars. Hoop God scanned himself last week so we can all see what he looks like in-game. Pretty hot. If you've ever wanted to be in a video game, trust me, GameFace HD is the easiest and best way to get it done, and you'll only find it in NBA Live. Now, once you're in game, you'll be able to express yourself any way you choose. As you progress, you'll use global XP earned from across the entire game to up your swag and improve your skill set. Now let's take a look at self-expression on the court. We are laser focused on giving you unparalleled control and best-in-class animation fidelity. First, we spent 2 years building a physics-based player movement system called Live Motion. Now, using an innovative approach to motion capture, we've literally created thousands of new animations. And paired with runtime physics, this results in contextual, free-flowing movement, like what you'd expect to see on the basketball court. Now, this dynamic nature of Live Motion keeps you in control of your player's movement. You won't feel like you're stuck in a scripted animation. This will truly free your game. Second, completely rebuilt passing and catching systems will allow you to distribute the ball exactly when and where you want with touch passing and dribble handoffs. This gives you never seen before options to move the ball around the perimeter. Next, let's take a look at the pick and roll. It's the bread and butter of today's NBA. And in these situations, NBA Live 16 gives you the type of control you've been asking for. Screen and rescreen. Choose whether the screener rolls, pops, or slips. Now you can choose how you defend it by showing, trapping the ball, or even switching. Finally, our players have also told us that they want more control when shooting the basketball. We've created a new shot system that gives you full control to release the ball when you want. So the longer you actually hold a button press, the later you'll release, giving you complete control of your shot in situations all over the court. We've never had this level of gameplay control before. So for those of you at E3, please come by and check it out. You really have to feel it to know just how much these new controls change the game. And later this summer, we're going to be revealing a new game mode. And let's just say we're committed to delivering a reliable and stable place to play basketball online with your friends. It's time to rise together. Now let's take a look at our trailer featuring footage captured entirely from in-game. Thank you.
West up. Turn the volume up and bang it out. This one is for the trunk. Wake up the neighborhood when it dump. Rather is ride basic.
Vous êtes fan de comment des jeux de EA sur Twitch? Parce que là, des jeux de sport, notamment NBA Live, là, c'est des franchises qui datent depuis longtemps. Mais moi, j'ai jamais été un grand fan des jeux de sport comme ça. Mais je suis curieux de savoir qu'est-ce que vous pensez de ça. C'est-tu une franchise que vous achetez d'une année à l'autre? Moi, la seule que je rachète d'une année à l'autre, c'est NHL. Mais oui, à partir du moment où on aime un sport, je suppose qu'on rachète le jeu qui vient avec à toutes les années. J'attends vos commentaires sur Twitch. This one is back.
Good afternoon. Let's talk about mobile. It's the single biggest gaming platform in the world. The sheer appetite for mobile games is staggering. Last year, we downloaded our games more than 750 million times across our consumers. That's 2 million times a day in more than 235 countries and territories. Most impressive.
Je veux dire que EA sont les premiers à nous apporter des chiffres de vente ou de téléchargement, alors que toutes les autres conférences jusqu'à maintenant, on nous avait pas mal épargné ce côté statistique-là.
With Need for Speed No Limits, we're pushing smartphones and tablets further than ever. We're also inspired by new devices. FIFA 15 Ultimate Team mobile players are obsessed with building squads, so we made it easy for them to manage their auctions right from their Apple Watch. We're delivering the amazing franchises you love most, from Madden to The Simpsons Tapped Out. But that's not all. I'm excited to announce that later this year, we're bringing you a brand new CCG role-playing game, Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. We believe this is the Star Wars game mobile players have been waiting for, loaded with characters you know and love. From the prequels and classic trilogies to the Clone Wars and more, it's a massive game that spans the entire Star Wars universe. You can collect, battle, and dominate with your favorite Star Wars characters and ships. And finally, let's welcome Mike Rasmussen to show you a little bit of Minions Paradise.
Nice. Thank you.
On est essentiellement dans une section mobile, donc un jeu Star Wars mobile et un jeu Minions Paradise. On sait que les Minions sont populaires ces temps-ci, donc un autre jeu mobile de Minions. Le dernier était un Endless Runner. J'ai hâte de voir celui-là. We're bringing that fantasy to life. Minions Paradise is a builder game that introduces you to Phil, a sweet yet subversive minion who's exclusive to the game.
Hide your bananas! The minions are on the vacation of their lives! And what fun! There's Charlie and his balloon animals! Barry and his famous burritos! Ken and his delicious cakes! Ah, and Phil. He usually ruins everything. Hey, Phil, maybe you can keep to yourself here. Do some harmless sunbathing. Oh, no! Phil! Look what you've done. Your buddies are furious that you've ruined their awesome vacation. You better do something quick. I think you'll need to do a little more than that.
All right, let's take a look at the game. Hello. Hi, Phil. First things first, what paradise would be complete without a tiki lounge? And Phil loves his tiki lounge. Check it out, Phil. Now, the Tiki Lounge becomes a focal point for the game, where you'll get quests and check in on Phil and his progress. Maybe this will help him win over his pals. Well, here come Phil's buddies, but they're still angry. Phil better act quick, so he gets the party started with some coconut drinks. But now he's out of coconuts. Hey, Phil, send your buddies out for more. What could go wrong, right? Well, with the minions, pretty much anything can go wrong. We always want you to be surprised and delighted by the trouble the minions get into. And we worked hand in hand with Illumination to create these unexpected moments that make this world come to life. I love that. You combine items in the island to create things that every minion needs, like throwing stars or swamp gas grenades. And you'll explore the island to find new activities to keep your minions' vacation going, like this water slide, or fishing, which quickly goes haywire when an
je sais pas quoi dire. Your water skiing. Ça a pas de l'air le fun. Ça a même pas de l'air le fun.
I can't wait for you to play this later this year. With endless surprises and chances to play with your minions, this is a vacation you'll never forget. And that's Minions Paradise. Thank you.
Shoulders above any other striker.
For me, the best player ever.
Football is in my heart, in my feet, in my body, in my soul. It has power like no other sport. It lifts an entire nation. It has the power to take our breaths away, to make us laugh, cry, and rejoice. I've scored over 1,000 goals. The only player to win 3 World Cups. Voted player of the century. My legacy? To be the man that created more moments of beauty than anybody else. Will my beauty ever be matched? We will see.
Ladies and gentlemen, the greatest football player of all time, Pelé.
Obrigado. Everything okay?
My pleasure. Come on in. Can you believe it? So I've got a really sore face. We've been spending a bit of time chatting, and my face has been grinning too much. Anyway. We wanted to get you here because you've got some amazing stories to tell. And you told me one earlier today about when you went to New York and how you coined the phrase, the beautiful game. Would you share it with everyone here?
No, first of all, thank you for the beautiful welcome.
That is the family of the sport, a family of football. Thank you. When we started to promote the soccer in the United States, I come upon New York Cosmos, and then we used to practice with the giant stage, yep. the American football there. And then some players say, oh, this is a beautiful game. I say, no, the beautiful game, the jogo bonito, is soccer. Soccer is jogo bonito. American football. Then I say, American football is too much Bambi, too much strong. Soccer is more intelligent. I started to tease my friends from New York. Then that's the reason we say the jogo bonito become known, the beautiful game. It's a beautiful.
So I wanted everyone to hear that story, because for me it's an amazing tale about how that phrase kind of came about to represent football or soccer. Yeah. And we really wanted to kind of take that idea of the expression and flair from the game of football and put it into FIFA, which is what the team have been working on this year. But the other thing I really wanted to ask you about is, when you think about those moments, those beautiful moments in the game of football, and think about recent matches, what do you think of? What thing springs to mind?
No, first of all, we have to be very careful when you see the game, when you was in the game.
Yeah.
Because when you stay in the game, as I have my 25 years there, lot of emotion, lot of things happen, you know? I think I told you about I score a lot of goal, bicycle. It's a beautiful bicycle kick, you know? When you dribble one, two, but the most difficult goals who I scored in my life was the penalty kick. you know?
Yeah, you said
that. You remember? I'm going to tell for the youngest. When I scored 1,000 goals, was a big party, you know, whole Brazil waited. I thought, okay, oh God, maybe I'm going to make go by head, go by bicycle, beautiful goal. Then it was a penalty kick. But it was more difficult, moment in my life, because I put the ball in a mark. Then I start, oh my God, I cannot miss. I cannot miss. It was a penalty kick, but it was more difficult for me. So I think this what the game bring to you, because it's different moment,
Awesome. I mean, again, just that idea of depending on the situation or the circumstance, the fact that's what makes it beautiful.
Yeah.
It can be a single moment, or it could be everything strung together. Yeah,
depending on the moment. For example, I have in my career, I have a lot of moments. For example, my first World Cup, I was with 16 years old to 17. In Brazil, in Sweden, and it was everything new for us. Even when we traveled to Sweden, when I get there, my first traveling outside of Brazil, 16 years old, I went there. The girls from Sweden, the blonde girl, she started to put them on my hair. I didn't understand well, my older players, because we have interpreted. It was the different, emotion was completely different. Fortunately, Brazil won the World Cup, I was 17. It was a different moment,
Amazing. So I think we could probably sit here forever. You talk about beautiful moments. This is a really beautiful moment for me personally. Thank you so much for coming here. I'm sure everyone is amazed by this. Thank you.
Keeps the ball rolling.
What a legend.
Thank you. Thank you.
You take care.
Thank you.
Take care.
Okay.
Thank you.
Nice to you.
That was kind of unbelievable. But we do have to actually get on and start to talk about the beautiful game in FIFA 16. Because gameplay's always been the soul of FIFA. This year, obviously, we want to innovate across the entire pitch.
Avec tout le respect que j'ai pour Pelé, c'est, je pense que c'est un mauvais endroit puis un mauvais moment pour lui. La conférence de EA tombe un peu à plat et je pense pas que les gens, ce qu'ils voulaient voir présentement, après avoir vu des chiffres, des jeux mobiles, ils voulaient voir une entrevue sportive avec Pelé, qui est une légende du sport hein, en passant, mais peut-être une question de timing hein, chez EA. Là, je pense que le timing est pas... Le timing de cette conférence-là n'est pas bon du tout. Mais au moins, on s'en vient avec Mirror's Edge Catalyst et Star Wars Battlefront prochainement.
So this year, you'll have better defensive shape on the pitch to help break down attacks and counter-attack when you win the ball. And in the middle of the pitch, you'll control the midfield, the battleground of any great match. Interception intelligence helps shut down options and close dangerous passing channels. And on the counter, passing with purpose lets you play sharp passes to slice through defenders. It's now a more considered build-up through the midfield, with more options than ever before. And in the final third, you want more moments of magic, more skills, better dribbling, all so you can create menacing attacks. And sometimes the best touch is the one that you don't take. So we've captured the movement of today's best player to bring you no-touch dribbling. Free yourself from the ball to buy time. Create separation and blow by your defender, just as Messi does when he's at his best. It's near limitless creativity and changes the game profoundly. And when you're in on goal, clinical finishing helps you create those wow moments only FIFA can deliver. From box to box, from sideline to sideline, we're innovating across literally every inch of the pitch so you can play your way. And for every fan, we're giving you the ability to compete at a higher level. Whether you're new to FIFA or play every season, FIFA Trainer will help dial up your game no matter your level. The controller language you see here on screen will change as you move around the pitch and bring you options sure to help you play better defense, make better passes, and hopefully score more goals. And this year, finally, we're giving you an amazing new way to play. For the first time ever in the FIFA franchise, women's teams are in the game. We've been working on this for years, and it's at the level of authenticity that FIFA's known for, thanks to our motion capture technology and our body and facial scanning. And our gameplay engine and physics engine give us the right platform to build out player-specific models and animations specific to the best female athletes in the world. It's huge news for the franchise and something myself and the FIFA team are immensely proud of. So, a balanced experience across the whole game, innovation across the entire pitch, complete at a higher level and new ways to play. And that's just the start. We have news on the rest of the game throughout the summer as we continue to make FIFA 16 a beautiful experience. And finally, I know it's unforgettable, I just want to remind you that Pelé was on stage with me about 3 minutes ago. How crazy was that? But now, to commemorate this huge moment, along with Pelé and our friend Leo Messi, we're dropping a special item into the account of all our loyal FIFA 15 Ultimate Team players. So go check it out at the end of the press conference and let's take a look at the beautiful game in FIFA 16.
Beautiful football. The game played by the entire planet. The game that brings us together. The game made up of many faces. But the beauty is in the moments. Powerful. Suspenseful. Stunning. Spine tingling. But for as much beauty as I have created, for as much beauty as I have experienced, I know I have seen nothing yet. But what is beauty if you cannot experience it? 16. Play beautiful.
What would life be like if we willingly gave away our privacy? What would our world look like if there were no governments, only corporations? Who would save us from our oppressors?
Ok, bon, enfin, on passe à Mirror's Edge Catalyst. Là, ça risque d'être beaucoup plus intéressant. Ça, c'est un titre que j'attends énormément.
These are questions you may ask yourselves, and these are the questions that inspired us as we set out to bring Mirror's Edge to a new generation of gamers. Welcome to Mirror's Edge Catalyst. This is a revolutionary action-adventure game where you will experience the origin story of our heroine, Faith. From a careless young woman to a fierce heroine who opens the eyes of an entire city. She's not your usual video game hero. And because this is a truly immersive first-person experience, you're not just watching the events unfold in front of you. You are Faith. She is graceful, elegant, and as efficient as she is powerful. She doesn't need any guns. Faith combines her momentum, martial arts combat, and her mastery of the environment. This environment is the City of Glass, built on the latest version of our Frostbite engine. It's beautiful and stylized. But behind the beautiful facade lies a dark truth. The city is ruled by the corporations, led by this man, Gabriel Kruger. There is no individual freedom. There is no privacy. You will uncover these secrets as you explore the city on your terms. There's plenty for you to do, and we're giving you the freedom of choice. There are story missions, activities like time trials and races, and environmental puzzles. Most importantly, there are no levels. There are no loading screens. You are truly free roaming. Fluid movement and combat in first person. Running free in a beautiful, massive city. Experiencing the rise of Faith. This is her origin story. And for those of you here at E3, you can come by and play it for yourself at the EA booth. Here's the world premiere of Mirror's Edge Catalyst, captured fully in engine, coming February 23rd, 2016.
On a une date de lancer pour Mirror's Edge qui va être au mois de février 2016. Ça va être très intéressant. Or spend it advancing yourself. A productive employee is a happy employee. Anyone can rise to a high caste level. Your possibilities are infinite. Personal freedom comes at a price. Be wary of policy breakers in our midst. Faith, are you there? Had a run with Kruger, but I got something for it.
What's coming, Faith? This city is changing, and not for the better. Unless, of course, we stop it.
You on the ground now!
Go on, girl. Save us all.
Wow. With the 42nd pick in the 2010 NFL Draft, the New England Patriots select Rob Gronkowski, tight end, Arizona.
Bon, parce qu'on n'a pas assez parlé de sport, après Mirror's Edge, on reparle de sport. Je ne peux plus contenir mon excitation.
Hi everyone, I'm Sean Grady, senior producer for Madden NFL.
Sean, that was a great example of how the New England Patriots drafted the right players in the right round and the right playmakers to build their current Super Bowl championship team. Hi everyone, I'm Robert Flores, I'm host of ESPN2's Fantasy Football Now, and spending time on the set all these years, I've learned two things. One, my hair looks great on the big screen, and that 40 million fantasy sports fans out there would say that their favorite part of playing fantasy football is the ability to draft their own team.
Okay, well, we've got something really exciting for those fantasy fans. It's called Draft Champions, and it's a brand new way to get the fantasy draft experience every day. Now, Draft Champions puts you in your own personal war room, starting your playmaker journey off the field. We built this mode for both our Madden players and the fantasy fanatics who love the excitement that come with drafting a fantasy team. And Madden mobile players, don't sleep on this. It's a great reason to check out the console experience. Now, it's similar to Madden Mobile and Ultimate Team. You'll build a current team, a team of current and legendary players. But what really sets Draft Champions apart is the fun, fast, multi-round draft. You're going to get three players to choose from in each round, so every draft is exciting and different. It's all about interesting decisions and how you choose to build your team. Now, Robert, we recorded you earlier. We've got your final three rounds of your draft here. All right. Let's see how you, a fantasy football expert, handled it. All right. So I see right away you're still short a quarterback. You haven't upgraded yet.
Well, sometimes, like I do in real fantasy football, I'll wait on getting a quarterback. I wanted a defensive back, DRC, a new member of the New York Giants. I went with him.
Okay, that's a great pick. A little risky leaving a quarterback in that late round. Now, this next round is probably your most difficult. A lot of great players on the board. What'd you decide here?
Absolutely. Look, any fan would love to get Jamal Charles with all his home run speed on their team. And then you got J.J. Watt, the reigning defensive player of the year, on their defensive line. But I don't know how you turned down the best receiver in the league for my money, Calvin Johnson, so I'm pumped to have Megatron on my roster.
Okay, I'm a little surprised to see you leave J.J. Watt on the board from your Houston Texans.
They are my team.
But not a bad pick. All right, in this final round, legends all over the board here. We all love legends. What'd you decide?
Well, look, you got the obvious quarterback choice there, but you got a couple of Hall of Famers. You got Derek Brooks and John Randall, exceptional defenders. But in the end, I needed that quarterback, so I go Randall Cunningham. He's got the big arm and the perfect fit to throw that ball downfield to Megatron. So okay. I went with Randall Cunningham.
Looks like a really solid draft there, a good team. If not, a little lucky with that quarterback coming in the final round. Worked out well. All right, once you've nailed the draft, this is where Madden takes fantasy to another level. Instead of passively watching the guys you drafted play, you get to be the playmaker on the field. You play with your team solo go online, challenge other players to see how your draft and your game stack up. And once you've completed your mini season, you'll be back at the drafting board to start a whole new run. One quick experience, something you could frankly do in a night.
That is awesome. Very cool. I know where a lot of fantasy fans and fantasy football players this season will be spending their time.
All right, well, we couldn't agree more. Robert, we appreciate you being out here as the fantasy expert voice today. Let's give a big round of applause for Robert Flores.
This was outstanding. Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. Okay, today's NFL is a passing league. So we've overhauled the entire passing game. Whether you're Odell Beckham Jr. making a gravity-defying catch or Patrick Peterson intercepting the ball for a game-winning touchdown, playmakers dominate the passing game on both sides of the ball. So we focused on three key positions: quarterbacks, receivers, and defenders in coverage. Let's start with quarterback. New body relative throws give you the chance to lead your tall receivers high above a defender's reach, or throw low on a curl route to wall off the defender, protecting both the ball and your receiver. As an example, if Russell Wilson would have used a body relative low throw to end the Super Bowl, we'd probably be referring to the Seahawks as the two-time defending champs. Now, catches in the NFL never cease to amaze me. They're one of the most exciting and dynamic plays in any sport. As a receiver, you can now choose from one of three new catch types to beat the competition and keep your drive alive. First, a possession catch will increase your chance of a completion to get that critical first down, but might sacrifice yards. Next, a rack, or run after catch. Adjust your route so you can attempt to gain extra yards after the catch. And finally, use an aggressive catch to attack the ball at its highest point.
Il fait intéressant, un suiveur sur Twitter me dit, Max, la conférence n'était pas supposée de se terminer à 17h. Je lui réponds oui, mais je pense que les producteurs se sont endormis et qu'ils ont oublié d'arrêter la conférence à 17h comme prévu. Trololol.
Madden NFL 16 is delivering tools so you can be the playmaker on the field as a quarterback, receiver, and defender in coverage. And with Draft Champions, you'll start your playmaker journey off the field in this exciting new fantasy-inspired mode. You'll have your first shot to prove you're the playmaker both on and off the field right here at E3, or for those of you at home when the game launches on August 25th. Now, let's take a look at the official Madden 16 E3 trailer.
Every now and then, someone comes along and changes everything.
The high-powered Packers have proven why they're at the top of the NFC. Cobb with a go-ahead score, that could mean the dagger for the Giants.
But finding them is easier said than done.
The Giants have been lackluster in two-minute drills all year. Can this be the one that changes their season? Manning drops back. He's tackled for a sack.
And at times, it seems hopeless.
No timeouts left. Could this be the last play of the game? The Giants need a touchdown.
Until you realize that there is an opportunity to do more. And in this very moment, you discover.
It's caught! Odell Beckham Jr.
It was you all along. The playmaker in Madden NFL 16.
Through my decade and a half in this industry, I've learned that every once in a great while, you can be part of something special. This is one of those moments. In the past 2.5 years, we've put some of EA's greatest talent and most advanced technology together with one of the most beloved sagas of our time, as we seek to create something that millions of fans around the world will love. The passion, creativity, and dedication come from our DICE studio in Stockholm. The technology is EA's own Frostbite game engine. And the game is, of course, Star Wars Battlefront.
Bon, enfin, la conférence est à peine de se terminer et on va parler de Star Wars Battlefront, donc ça risque d'être très intéressant. J'ai hâte de savoir si le jeu va avoir évolué et si on va avoir un petit peu plus de modes disponibles. On devrait en savoir plus parce que le jeu va être lancé au mois de novembre.
Right now, the sophistication of Frostbite is bringing a galaxy far, far away to life like never before. In just a few moments, you'll see how tools like physically based rendering, new weathering systems, and a technique called photogrammetry are being used to create an incredibly detailed, immersive, and completely authentic experience in Star Wars Battlefront. We're still only beginning to see what Frostbite can truly achieve. But the results are completely stunning. So let us show you, made by developers that love Star Wars, for fans that love Star Wars, let's step into the world of Star Wars Battlefront.
I'm Sigurlína Ingvarsdóttir. And I have the awesome job of leading a talented, passionate team at DICE on Star Wars Battlefront. Like many of you, I can't remember a time when Star Wars wasn't a part of my life. And one of my earliest memories is of seeing a dark, ominous being that I was terrified of. That being, whose mask still has the ability to strike fear in me, is Darth Vader. I remember playing with the old action figures or attaching a clothespin to a magic marker to create a blaster pistol so that I could run around shooting lasers at imaginary stormtroopers. Today, by far the best place to truly lose yourself and interact with Star Wars is video games. With Star Wars Battlefront, we will immerse players in an incredibly authentic, visually stunning universe. And we've gotten amazing access from our partners at Lucasfilm. They've opened up their sacred vaults to us so that we can recreate the props and locations from the original trilogy. When you fly in an X-Wing, it's the real X-Wing. We will give you the chance to live out the Star Wars battle fantasies you've always dreamed of, and we can't wait to see all of the new memories you will create on your own. We have a great amount of depth. A variety of multiplayer modes that range from large-scale battles between 40 players all the way down to 8-player modes that deliver a more intimate experience between squads of Rebel and Imperial soldiers. Have you ever wanted to fly an X-Wing? Soaring above the skies, skimming the rims of canyons on Tatooine while you dogfight against a squad of TIE fighters? Or have you fantasized about being one of the most iconic heroes or villains in the Star Wars universe? Wielding a lightsaber and using the Force, being the boss of a multiplayer match, and single-handedly turning the tide of an epic Star Wars battle. And if you're not in the mood for multiplayer, we have Star Wars Battlefront missions where you can jump in and play against AI, alone or with a friend, including split-screen co-op and one-on-one battles. Now, it's been 2 months since we revealed Star Wars Battlefront, and we've been amazed by the response. But if there's one thing that's come through loud and clear, is that you want to see gameplay. So that's what we're going to do right now. What we're about to show you today is Walker Assault, one of our largest modes. This mode was inspired by the Battle of Hoth from The Empire Strikes Back. As the Empire, you must escort AT-AT walkers towards the Rebel base to destroy it. And as the Rebels, you must do everything you can to stop them. And while you will see a lot of things that remind you of that iconic battle, when you play the game your way, anything is possible. This was all captured on a PlayStation 4, and you will see the battle from the vantage point of both the Empire and the Rebels. Now, let's play Star Wars.
Bon, c'est ça qu'on veut voir. On veut voir le jeu, pas des photos et tout. Bon, des vraies images du jeu sur PlayStation 4. Voyons voir.
Walker down! vehicles have activated the uplink station. We must shut it down.
On a vraiment l'impression que Star Wars Battlefront ressemble à un Battlefield relooké complètement, mais dans l'univers de Star Wars. Mais c'est pas nécessairement un défaut parce que Battlefield propose tout le temps un multijoueur vraiment cool. Fait que si on utilise toutes les capacités qui existent dans l'univers de Star Wars, ça va être vraiment cool. Quelle finale avec Luke Skywalker et Darth Vader. Donc c'est très prometteur. Moi je suis enfin un peu de hype de la part de Yi, j'ai vraiment hâte de voir.
Coming November 17th. That's our show for today. For those of you here in LA, we'll see you at our booth where everything is hands-on and ready to play. If you're joining us on the web, visit livetoplay.ea.com where we'll have more behind the scenes content and stories. Thanks to all of our awesome teams, thanks to Palais, and thanks to all of you for joining us. Have a great show, everyone, and wherever you are, we hope you make some time to play. Thank you.
Alors voilà pour la fin de la conférence de Electronic Arts. C'était globalement une conférence assez plate. Hein? On va se dire les choses comme ça doit être. Ça a ouvert bien avec Mass Effect 4, donc une nouvelle opus, mais après ça on est tombé dans une succession de jeux pour mobile, de présentation de sport, conférence avec Pelé. J'ai beaucoup de respect pour le monsieur, mais c'était pas nécessairement un bel endroit pour lui rendre hommage. Et donc, une conférence qui a manqué beaucoup, beaucoup de rythme. Donc, globalement, trop de sport et tout. Donc, on sent un petit peu qu'on cherchait à remplir du contenu chez Electronic Arts cette année et que c'est un peu raté. Ça se sentit beaucoup dans le rythme. Par contre, une belle finale avec Star Wars Battlefront qui propose une jouabilité vraiment, vraiment intéressante, très forte. Et une finale avec la présentation où est-ce qu'on a vu un croisement de lightsaber entre entre Luke Skywalker et Darth Vader, donc c'était vraiment très cool. Là, on entend les enfants crier, c'est l'heure de souper. Donc, moi, je vous laisse pour l'instant, on va reprendre ça. On va reprendre ça pour la conférence de Ubisoft des 18h, heure de l'Est. Moi, je vous laisse là-dessus et on se donne un rendez-vous un peu plus tard. Bye bye.